The rise of India and China's space agencies, ISRO and CNSA, are a result of brilliant minds wanting to achieve great things for their country and humanity. Now, it's often assumed that organizations like space agencies operate the same across the board. And yeah, sure, in many cases that's true. However, what are the differences between ISRO and the CNSA? Hey, welcome back to FD Facts, everybody. My name is Leroy Kenton, and yeah, we got another space agency video. We're talking about ISRO and the CNSA, and we're gonna take an inside look of what they're really all about. So if you love learning about outer space and space technology, space travel, all of that stuff, don't forget to leave a like on this episode. And if this is your first time here to FDD Facts, just hit that subscribe button as well as that bell notification. And I also have a link to playlist below where you can watch more episodes like this. Okay, so first up, I want to start off with ISRO. Now, ISRO stands for the Indian Space Research Organization, and it was formed in August 15th, 1969, and it operates under the Department of Defense of the Indian government. ISRO's headquarters are in Bengaluru, India, and its primary spaceport is the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Andhra Pradesh, India. And the vision of ISRO is to harness space technology for national development while pursuing space science and planetary exploration. ISRO operates with an estimated budget of $1.6 billion US, and roughly 16,072 staff members work with the organization. Now I'm gonna introduce the CNSA, and that stands for the National Space Administration of China. Now, this is also a government agency, and it's responsible for civil space management as well as international space cooperation. So they look for ways in which China can work with other countries in space exploration, space research, and all of that. Now, the CNSA was formed on April 22 of 1993, and their headquarters is in the Haidian District in Beijing, China. The CNSA was formed when the Ministry of Aerospace was split into the CNSA and the China Aerospace Corporation, which also goes by CASC. Now, when you compare the CNSA to other major space agencies in the world, the CNSA is not involved in the International Space Station. They operate with an estimated budget of $11 billion, and according to their official website, the CNSA strives to implement for aerospace activities to develop them into a stable, orderly, healthy, and coordinated manner. While at the same time, I'm representing the Chinese government in organizing or leading activities such as foreign exchanges and cooperation in the aerospace field. Now, just to give you a little bit more clarification in what these space agencies do, when it comes to ISRO, their objective is to use space technology and its applications for various different tasks. And the headquarters of ISRO, they're responsible for coordinating programs such as satellite communication, Earth observation, you know, space science, disaster management, as well as other things like international cooperation. So yeah, they're always looking for ways in which India can work with other countries as well on space exploration, among several other things. So the Department of Space is under the Space Commission, and it manages several different agencies and institutions through ISRO. And many of these different agencies are used for research facilities, test and launch facilities, as well as for research. Now, when it comes to the CNSA, they were established as a government institution to really develop and fulfill China's international obligations. And their main responsibilities are signing government contracts in the space area on behalf of different organizations, as well as intergovernmental scientific and technical exchanges, and also being in charge of the enforcement of national space policies, as well as the enforcement of the national space policies and managing the national space science technology and industry. Now, for the administrators that work with the CNSA, they're appointed by the State Council. So that was your brief side-by-side comparison and looking at the differences between ISRO and the CNSA. Let me know what other space-related episodes you want to see next. I'm also excited to see what these organizations are going to discover when it comes to outer space. I mean, like India and China, those are like some brilliant people just like working at it. And thank you so much for learning with me here on FDD Facts. You can follow me on social media. Those links are below. And I can't wait to see all of you next time. All right, everybody who made it to the end of this episode, here is a playlist where you can check out more educational videos like this, more list videos, as well as we have playlists on the different countries and cultures from all around the world. We have videos dedicated to expand your knowledge of our world, and be sure to tune into FDD Facts daily for new episodes.